Hello and welcome to RTC on Channel 4. I'm Abby Malko, and here with me today is Greg Brown, the Rochester Youth Baseball League president. How are you, Greg?
Fine, Abby. How are you?
Good. Would you like to tell us a little bit about the history of the Youth Baseball League and how you got into it?
Oh, the history. Well, that goes way back somewhere around 1955 is when the papers I can find that when the league was set up, incorporated. And it was Rochester Little League Incorporated then. They were actually sanctioned Little League. And they were sanctioned Little League clear into, I think, the late 80s, somewhere in there. And now we're in Town and Country. But the league got started back then by a few guys. I believe Bob Follinger was one of them. My father was another one. When he moved to town, we moved to town in the 56. And he started his own business here in town and got involved in Little League with several other gentlemen that that I would have to go back and look up and remember their names. Now that I'm getting to that point, I'm getting older and forgetting things. Anyway, they started this league back then, and then they went into the senior league part of it, which is for the older kids, the 13 to 15-year-olds league, and that's when the other diamond, the bigger diamond, came into play towards the middle 60s, somewhere in there is when they put that diamond in for to keep the kids interested in playing baseball all the way into the high school era, because we didn't have any programs around here like that at that time, so I was told. I wasn't born until 60, so this stuff went on a little before me. But it's been most of my life. I was born and raised around it. My father was involved in it for 35, 40 years, something like that anyway. And it's been fun. I've got into it ever since I was born, like I said, and played in the league. And then always helped my dad as far as got into coaching. Myself, I've been coaching probably close to 30 years, somewhere in there. I've coached a lot of kids in this community amongst my father. And when my father died, I couldn't believe how many guys came out that were at the funeral and, you know, told me, hey, you know, your dad coached me, you know. And I met so many people over the years through baseball. And it's been a fun experience. And I've thought about how many games I've coached, and I don't know, it's been quite a bit.
I can imagine. Would you like to tell us some of the responsibilities, which we sure you have many, as the president of the Youth Baseball League?
Oh, well, yeah, there are quite a bit of responsibilities. One's making sure that you have a good program you're running, and so you can keep the youth out there and keep them interested, make sure you have good people underneath you. We have a board of 16 people on our youth board, plus me as league president, so there's not just me always making the decisions. It's a group of us. This year I got one of the best boards I've had in years helping out, guys that want to help out on the ball field, guys helping raising funds. You know, that's another responsibility as far as being president, is keeping the league financially stable to where you can keep buying new equipment, keep improving your grounds, make sure the grounds look nice, you know, the maintenance, the mowing, the fertilizers, the irrigation, that type of thing take a considerable lot of money. You know, making sure your outfield, that we have an outfield fence out there on the Little League diamond there that has sponsors on it, and without all those people that help pay for those, renew their sign sponsorship and sponsor the teams down there, the league wouldn't be like it is today. There's been, this community's really supported this league very well ever since it was started back in the 50s. And there's some sponsors down there that are still down there ever since I've been around it. So that's good for the community. You know, Rochester Telephone's been one of them that's been a big supporter down there. We've had people like Smith Sawyer and Smith, First Federal Savings Bank, and I'm probably going to miss a couple and kick myself in the rear. Rochester Glass is one of them.
Cannot forget that one.
No. And the responsibility-wise, it's making sure that the people underneath me know, understand what their roles are and their jobs are. For so many years, a lot of it was put on me, and now I have guys stepping up that want to help and do things, which is really great. It takes a lot of pressure off of me. You know, we got to make sure you have stuff for your concession stands all organized, you know, organizing the parade, the just all the stuff that we do down there, making sure the field's ready to go. You know, like tomorrow is going to be our opening day again. You know, we got our first, this is the first time in, I think, somewhere around 17, 18 years that it's been rained out on opening day back on April 28th. So we rescheduled it so we can still have our opening day ceremonies and everything. And that's another thing. You, when you run into rainouts or anything like that, you as president have to call all your other chain of guys down below so they can call their guys and everyone gets the word. There was a day where I was making a majority of phone calls and it was got old, but and it takes a lot of time, just a lot of time to be the president down there if you want to do it right.
Well, yeah, and we appreciate everything you do, and I'm sure all the boys that play in the league obviously respect everything that you've done. And one of my questions was, now that your boys are older and they're not necessarily in the league, what has made you stay and be incorporated and obviously become the president?
Well, a lot of it's something I just like to do, for one. I enjoy being around the kids. It keeps me younger. And my wife, she's down there and helping out. She runs a stand. We're involved. And without my kids in there, it's a little bit easier to do because you don't have what people, you know, and everyone knows it goes on no matter what sport you're in. There's always the talk, oh, that's the coach's kid, that's
politics.
This and that. Politics, if you want to call it that. And I try to take that out of there and be fair to everybody, and I can have more of an objective opinion, I feel, to keep the league running the direction it needs to run. Mm-hmm. And that's what I would like to see continued, because we have ages from 4 to 15 in this league, and we have this year we have 90 some kids in T-ball between the ages of 4 and 5. We have 92 kids.
Wow.
Yeah. So the program is building every year. What keeps me doing this is the people that come out and help, the new people that step up to be involved, to want to do things. I like to oversee that, make sure everything goes good. Make sure if there's any parent issues or anything like that, I take care of all that type of thing too. Try to keep everything running smooth, you know, just try to keep it one big happy family, because if you want to have a successful program, you got to make sure most of the people are happy. I mean, you're not going to please everybody.
Of course
but,
not.
But we try to, and we try to keep a good program going, try to keep good coaches involved, which I also coach a Tri-County travel team that we started here, the league got involved with 4 years ago, and we've been real successful in that. And been real successful in the town and country league we play in at tournament time. We have a real good success down there. Now, something I've been trying to get done for the last probably 10 years is trying to get these outlying communities such as Kewana, 12 Mile, and Fulton involved in our 12-year-old league. We have in our Babe Ruth League, our 13 and 15-year-old league, we already have teams that come in from out of town and everybody play here. And I've been trying to get that done down in our 10 and 11, 12-year-old leagues because their numbers are dropping. Our numbers are increasing, so I feel we're doing something right in our program if we're getting numbers out increase. And like I said, it's not just me that can take credit for that. I have a lot of support from behind me of people going out and trying to get the kids to come out, get them out of the house, get them off the PlayStations, get them, you know, get outside and play.
Yeah.
So, but this year we have Fulton, 12 Mile, and Kewana have joined our regular rec league, we call it, and they each have one team in it, and our teams, our 6, 11, 10, 11, and 12-year-old teams, our major league teams, they travel each to one of these communities one time, so they get a chance to travel. And then their kids come here and play each a game, so play our teams each once. And we also do that down in our minor league, but those kids don't travel. Those Kewana and 12, or Fulton and 12 Mile are the only two that come here and play in that league. It gives them extra games to play, gives them some better competition and experience. I know the kids from, we've already been into this 2 weeks now, and the feedback I'm getting is real positive from all the communities, Q1 to 12 Mile and Fulton, and from our coaches and our kids. I've asked the kids how they have enjoyed it, and it gives them a chance to feel like they're on an all-star or a travel team. Even though it's their regular team, they get to travel and play to another community. So that gives kids that don't get that opportunity to be on an all-star or travel team or be on the road, gives them that opportunity to find out what it's like to play somewhere else. So
yeah.
And it gives them better experience. So it's stuff like that that keeps me wanting to come back. I keep trying to make the league grow, trying to make it a nicer park and a nicer place to play for kids. And, you know, I owe it all to my dad.
Well, that's awesome. And the community, I know everybody appreciates everything you do, and hopefully keep up the good work. And we want to wish you good luck tomorrow at opening day. And hopefully all the viewers can come out throughout the spring and the summer and watch the boys play some baseball. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time on Channel 4.
Thank you.
Thank you. right, everybody. We'll get things started here. First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for the patience from 2 weeks ago when it rained out. That's the first time in about 17, 18 years that I can remember it's ever been rained out on opening day. Ironically, we had Mark Miller this year. Well, originally we was going to have Dick Belcher do it, then with Miller leaving the school system, we were going to have him do the first pitch. And Mark couldn't be here because he's down in Florida prepping for football down there. And he's going down to Rick Marcus. So the last time it got rained out was when Mark Miller was president. Anyway, so this year we're going to have Mr. Belcher will be here. He was gladly to step up to the plate or to the mound, however you want to look at that. Okay. We've had a pretty good year so far this year. I know we're 2 weeks into the season. Looks like things are going pretty good. The guys are having fun. The out-of-town guys, how are your games going down to Fulton, the 12 mile, if you wanted those fun guys? Huh? Yeah, kind of. Parents don't like it at 350, 375 a gallon, I know that. So, anyway, I hope that goes good. That's some new adventure we started, trying to get that done for several years. Get county ball here, and us go there. Kind of gives the kids a different turn on baseball. The parents also. This year I got a few thank yous to go out for. Is the Eagles and the Moose Lodge went together and bought us a new liner for our field here, so want to give them a big hand. Thank you. The Moose and Eagles appreciate that. We need that liner. That way we can put our other one over there so the guys don't have to keep going back and forth. It makes things a lot easier. On our batting cage, we finally got our batting cages up, and we're not completely done. We need to do some painting to them yet. We have a third cage that's eventually going to go up as soon as we get some money. A bunch of us board members and a few outside people helped. We pooled our money together. We decided we needed to get something done. Fred McLaughlin with M&M Irrigation was kindly able to donate all the pipe out there, and it's going to do it. See, a big rock show would have a sound man. I can't afford it. It's not the budget. We got our, Fred had a bunch of irrigation pipe, was able to have his guys come in and drill all the holes and set all the posts and set that. They did a wonderful job over there. We got two of our nets up. And also, our EMC came in and gave the guys a hand to put up the holes. Also in that, I'd like to thank the Phil Dalton Foundation for donating the money, some of the money for it. Also, we got to thank Shepherd Chevrolet this year. Is the power system's going to, PA is going to go out here, so that'll be in the budget definitely. Shepherd Chevrolet again this year has stepped up to the plate again, going to donate another $500 to the Chevy Youth Baseball. And they gave us a bunch of shirts we're going to hand out later, try to get those out to the kids. And they gave us some other equipment that'll get distributed later, some tees and that type of thing. So thanks again to Shepherd Chevrolet. Give them a big, all those people a big hand. Also this year had a gal, Terry Gearhart, wanted to do something. Since we weren't able to get our car on the ice this year, she wanted to help do something to help raise some money for us. So she is going around with the 50-50 drawing, which we will be drawing here later. And you don't have to be present to win, but those sales have went pretty decent. I'm not sure how much money we do have to split, but it will be a little bit. So thanks, Terry. And also one other thing, the kids this year, we're selling cups. I don't know if anyone's seen them or anything, but contact any of the coaches, any of the players. And these are a three-dimensional cup, with whether it's a Green Bay Packer cup, you know, that's, no? Well, okay. Okay, how about a cup? Bears Cups? IU, there you go. Purdue. Notre Dame, no? Alright. Anyway, there are four of these cups. They are in a pack. They're for $15. They make great Christmas gifts, whatever gifts for anybody. They're machine or dishwasher safe. They're great cups, great support for our league. We haven't had a fundraiser other than Car on the Ice, and since Mother Nature wasn't good to us this year. We got a lot of guys that stepped up to the plate this year as far as the board members going out and helping get and raising money this year. So thanks a lot for all my board members. You guys do a great job. Okay, I've stood up here and talked long enough now. See, it was cutting out. Now it's time for me to get done. So, we're going to do player introduction now, and that is Mr. Brian Holcomb.
Ball Astros, Carson Bailey.
Carson. Right here, Carson.
Brian Bando.
Awesome. Right here. Right. Nope. Not doing it. Not doing it.
Jake Merrill. Ashton Russell.
No.
Davis Reed.
David.
Curtis Smith. Tristan Smith. Reed Spencer. Emma Sprady.
Come on, Curtis. Right here.
Caleb Tyler.
Good job.
Coaches
that's
of the team right all right Astros right are Kyle Bando and Kevin Reed.
Awesome. Awesome. Good job. Okay, can we go back to this spot?
I thought we were.
Let's go back to this spot.
Next up is the Blue Jays, James Gardner. Christian Kimberlin. Carson Matthew. Connor Matthew. Skylar Mitchell. Brandon Oliver. Joshua Stacy. Mason Young. Peyton Young, Adarius Ramstead. Coaches are Matt Young and Trey Mitchell.
Next is the Pirates. Deck that guard.
like an angel, bro.
Wesley Steininger, Trace Meade,
Hands in. One. Ready. One, three. One, two,
three. Tyler Campbell. Luke Cumming. Evan Caskey. Quentin Kelly. Davis Kane. Christian Ramirez. Thatcher Sansford. Alaysa Sarver. David St. Clair. Coaches from the Tigers are Joe Murray, Scott King, and Brian.
All right, guys. Let's go.
Next is the minor league, starting with the Angels. Caleb Bailey. Evan Elliott. Cameron Johnson. Peyton McTaggart. Reese Freeney. Gavin Schamburger. Alex Swank. William Urbach, Cole Wien, and Logan Young. Coaches for the Angels are Ben Schamburger, Karen Schamburger, and Will Urbach.
Angels!
Timothy Anderson, Glenn McCurry, Derek McBoston, Mark Schufeld, Tatum Smith, Aaron Swingo, and Eli Swingo. Coaches for the Cubs are Fred McLaughlin and Keith McGriff. Aaron Kennedy, Logan Chappell, Aaron Cox, Ty Cox, Stephen Elder, Jacob Escobar. Jacob.
Damon Godell, Chase Thomas, Micah Town, Austin Utter, Terry Walker, Tyler Walker, and Zane Young. Coaches are Evan Young, Joe Heckerborn, and Greg Ballew. Next are the Cubs. Caden Bixler, Jacob Bowman, Riley Hicks, Josh Leese, Matt Leese, Braxton McLaughlin, Cole Meixel, Alan Pfeiffer, Ian Hughes, Jordan Raderstorff, Jeffrey Rupert. Coaches are Troy Bixler, Fred McLaughlin, and Mike Leese. Next are the Orioles. Adam Brown, Wilson Dalton, Caleb Easterday, Dylan Hippensteel, Tanner Medina, Aaron Miser, Peyton Prater, Joey Rock, David Sager, Adam Scheidler, and Reginald Vasquez. Coaches are Ben Dalton, Bob Prater, Dave Easterday, and Wayne Eddington. Next are the Pirates. Devin Bando, Andrew Bankson, Aaron Brooks, AJ Davis, Peyton Hibner, Ethan Huskins, Nolan Long, Jacob Miller, Tyler Mulvaney, Austin Thomas, Skylar Ranger, and Elijah Yarber. Coaches for the Pirates are Marty Davis, Joe Bankson, and Kyle Bando. And the last is the Red Sox. Bryce Abbott. Bryce Albright. Danny Alexander. Andrew Bach. Blake Bradley. Chandler Bright. Jacob Good. Kobe McAllister. Caleb Miller. Hunter Dard and Drew Saylor. Coaches for the Red Sox are Brian Holcomb, Austin Shepherd, Kyle McLaughlin, and Justin Bond.
I want to thank all the parents and everything for getting your kids out of the house this year. Like I said, we have 92 kids in T-ball this year between the ages of 4 and 5. I know we restructured some of our other leagues with ages down to pony. With the pitching machine, we brought up a lot of younger kids already. This will only help our program later on down the road as these kids get older. It's just going to take a little while. So I appreciate everybody's patience and cooperation there with us. Down in our minor league, we have 8 and 9-year-olds there. We have 70-some kids there. We have close to 70-some kids up in our major league. So we have a lot of good turnout for baseball this year, and I wanted to again thank the parents for getting your kids out. All right. I'll go down to sponsors here, these people that sponsor our teams and sponsor our program. Veterans of the Foreign Wars, Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, Fulton County Tire, M&M Irrigation, First Federal Bank, Shepherd Chevrolet, Rochester Rotational Molding, Smith Farms, Casey's General Store, Advanced Guttering, Beacon Credit Union, Blueprint Construction, Fraternal Order of Police, U.S. Metals, E&B Paving, Dairy Queen, The Tire Store, Rochester Telephone Company, First Source Bank, Arbor Woods Apartments, Auto Park, Rochester Boat Company, Dean's, Woodlawn's Pediatrics, Rochester Iron and Metal, Webb's Family Pharmacy, Tidewater, Culligan. We have some additional sponsors. We have Airbag, Burger King, Fulton Industries, J&J Truck Repair, Meyer Services, Morris Excavating, Moose Lodge 1107, Mike Sales Company, Rochester Glass, Rochester Rotational International, Rochester Rotary International, my bad. State Farm Insurance and the Winning Edge. Everybody, let's give all these people a great hand. They put out a lot of money for all this to happen. let me tell you, it's not easy getting all these people out here. And it's a tough job, so I personally thank everybody, too.
Pray with me. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for an awesome day, for the opportunity to play baseball. We thank you for all the awesome coaches and volunteers who helped make this possible. We pray for the kids this year, Lord. We pray that they have a great time, a lot of fun, learn the fundamentals, keep them safe, Lord. And we thank you for every single person in uniform. It keeps our country safe so that we can do things like this and gather together. For those that are serving our country today, we thank you for their service. For those veterans who have served in the past, we thank you for their sacrifices and what they've done for us. Most of all, Jesus, we thank you for your love, your amazing love that allows us to have life and the opportunity to experience something different inside of each one of our hearts. It's in your awesome name that we pray. Amen.
And now, if you'll all turn to center field to face the flag for our national anthem, Gretchen Copeland will be singing that.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight?